It's Brooke and Jeffrey in the morning, and it's time for the radio segment that strongly supports moths.
Moths?
Moths?
Oh,
moths.
Hates moths.
Oh, wait, moths? Like the bug?
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, they do not.
What?
Kill them.
What, Brooke? Because moths aren't as attractive as butterflies, that means they don't deserve to thrive and be happy? I forgot that you only advocate for beautiful people and beautiful things.
Hate moths. You never know where they're going to go, okay?
Lambs, well, 99% of the time.
Maybe, Brooke, maybe moths are beautiful on the inside.
Oh, yeah, bro.
And that's the spirit of this segment. What's on your mind?
Yeah, let's dissect them all. Open
where we
them up.
Go no! around the room and we listen to the alluring thoughts that are happening inside of you, no matter how hideous you might be on the outside.
So you're kind of like a moth, Brooke.
Oh, wow.
Let's start with our most beautiful member of the morning show, on the inside at least. Brooke, what's been on your mind?
You know, I'm sorry, I don't mean to direct this at Alexis.
Uh-oh.
Seriously?
But you're pointing and looking at her.
Her generation.
Okay.
Weak.
Oh!
Weak. And I'll tell
you physically.
Okay, listen. My neighbors had a party over the weekend.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So my husband and I popped by.
Okay.
Nice.
Uninvited.
Yeah. Hey, we heard you guys love music.
We're young.
Quite a few couples that are in their early 20s, like 24-ish, right?
Okay.
It is 10:30. Two of them are like, "Huh, I'm exhausted. We gotta go home." I'm like, "What?
Okay.
I'm like, what? What could you possibly be tired from? You're 24. You literally all you had to do today was keep yourself alive." Okay. Then another one of them was like, "Let's do shots." I'm like, "Okay, fine." And she's like, "Do a shot with me."
I'm
like,
attitude.
And you said, "No, I'm too old."
I said, "Of course I'll do a shot with you." Right?
Yeah, wow. Tequila.
And so I take a shot, easy.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Uh-huh. She takes two drinks to get her shot down. A.
Oh, rookie mistake.
Is like choking. Like,
Something. Oh, you inhaled instead of exhaled.
And then 15 minutes later has to go home as well. What happened to you guys?
Your problem with the younger generation is they aren't as heavy alcoholics as you are.
Also, Brooke, maybe they were leaving to go somewhere else without
people. Oh. They were. I watched them go home and turn their lights off across the street.
Okay.
They were like, "Let's just pretend that we're canceling the party so these geezers leave, and then we'll turn it back up once the buzzkill's gone."
My husband and I were like, "Well, I guess that was the party.
Yeah.
Well, it's over now."
I'm not surprised. You're shaming them for drinking the entire night. They don't want this to continue anymore.
The shots were their idea, Jeffrey. I'm just going to say, if you want to do a shot, be able to take it like an adult.
Okay. Okay. You can come party with me and my friends and see what you think.
You can't put pepper on your macaroni and cheese. I don't think I'm gonna trust, I can keep up. You can't. I'm just gonna tell you now you can't.
Shot war. Let's do it live on the air.
This is a challenge.
The struggle continues. Jose, what's on your mind?
Well, I have an interesting story. A girl showed up recently to my new apartment to hang out.
Okay.
And,
which is exciting.
It was exciting because I got a new place. It's still not even fully furnished, but it was nice to have company.
Yeah.
So a girl shows up, takes a shot right when she gets there.
Okay.
Right?
Is she young? It didn't go down well.
Yeah, she may have came from your party.
Yeah, sure.
But she was, she's in her 20s, and, so she takes a shot, kicking it. I'm like, cool. And within the first 20 minutes, an awkward moment happens where she's like moving in closer. We're vibing. I'm thinking she's like, this is a kiss moment.
Yeah, sounds great.
And then I go in for the kiss, and then she turns her head.
Oh.
And I kiss the cheek, which is ouch, right?
Oh. Yeah,
I was like, whoa, okay, obviously I read the situation wrong, which is fine.
Yeah.
Like I said, she's only been here for 20 minutes.
You can bounce back.
We don't have to be kissing. It's totally whatever. Okay, I read that wrong. 10 minutes later, we're talking about normal stuff. Then she apologizes and says that she does want to kiss me.
Okay.
So I'm like, oh.
Mixed signals?
Okay, but now we're like in a weird zone in between.
Now we're talking about it?
Yeah, see, and now we're like in that zone where we're like not in the friend zone, but we're not in the romantic zone.
No.
We're in a weird like.
Yeah, analyzing zone.
Yeah. So then she kisses me really quick. And then she's like, you know what? I don't think we're vibing. And she gets her keys and she leaves.
No,
she left.
And she just left. And it was the fastest date I've ever been. I was so confused.
Was she there for 25 minutes?
And she was literally in and out 25 minutes. I was like, okay, well, have a good day.
It sounds like she just used your place to pre-funk.
she kind of did.
Before she went to the
She's
next
like,
place.
She's like, you have alcohol? Yeah. I like yeah. that.
So, yeah, so I sold that bottle of tequila in my...
In my experience, I'm sure she was in bed by 10:30. Yeah. Okay,
social media coordinator Alexis, tell us what's been on your mind.
So I've been thinking about buying a bike, you guys.
Okay, like a bicycle.
Yeah. Okay.
Oh, God, I thought you were saying motorcycle. Yeah. I was like, please, any police listener,
don't
let this happen.
Pedals, you know,
A two-wheeler, or are you going with the tricycles?
No, gears. Gears and everything.
Great.
So I borrowed my roommates to get to my job at the coffee shop the other day to test it out, see if I like it.
Okay.
And I heard it was a six-minute bike ride. Took me 20.
Oh, 20. Wow. And you're athletic, too.
I haven't biked in years, and I was on my phone, so I went the wrong way.
You were on your phone while you were biking?
You can't even text and bike.
Yeah, I can.
Right. Oh, my gosh.
I was on TikTok. God. But anyways, so I get to work. I'm, like, late, and I'm sweating. It's so hot, you guys.
Okay.
I get to work. I'm, like, walk my bike in because I forgot a lock for outside.
Of course.
And I can't get my helmet off. I literally could not unlock it.
What do you mean?
Like, I was just so flustered and hot and tired and late.
Please tell me you left it on the whole
shift. I had to work for a few minutes till my coworker could come help me get it off.
Wait, so people were ordering drinks from the lady wearing a biking
but
helmet.
But I bet you got extra
dorky
tips.
Helmet. No. And then just when I think it can't get any worse, I have to bike home. And I'm done. And so I'm biking back, I'm sweating, and it's like late in the evening, you know, so there's just tons of hot guys shirtless, and I'm there in my stupid helmet.
You're like, hey, boys, I can't get this off.
Sweating, walking my bike at this point, because I couldn't make it up the hill.
Oh my God, what a mess.
I was humiliated. It took me so long to get home, you guys.
But, so you're not going to get a bike now?
But see, the thing is, you know, like, after you work out, you kind of like, that was kind of good. Like a weird, toxic way you want to go back to it. So I'm debating if I get a bike still, you know?
You're never going to get a hot boyfriend.
Well, unless she gets a really simple helmet to wear.
Do you have to wear a helmet?
They already are simple. I don't have to be a click of the thing off and
on. Can I, like, cut it out so my hair shows more?
No.
Okay, well, I don't know.
Anyways.
Wear a helmet.
Or just drive. Why don't you just drive?
No, scooter it. That's what the hot guys
want. I don't know. Everyone says biking's good. It's cool.
Well, maybe put your phone down while you're
Anyways, it was a nightmare, guys.
Yikes.
Jeffrey, what's on your mind?
I mentioned last week that I was going to be emceeing a live event for a big charity gala.
You had to do the auction part, too.
Yeah, I was nervous, not just for the emcee, but because I learned days before I was going to be the auctioneer.
Which is a hard job.
It's something I've never done again and something you're supposed to go to school to learn how to do. So,
yeah, seriously.
Of course, when I mentioned that to my co-hosts here, your immediate reactions were, oh, no.
Not good.
Jeff,
not good.
You're screwed.
Yeah.
And I thought, yeah, you're right. Like, this is not going to go well. But something magical happened that night.
Right.
Something unexpected.
Okay.
Your boy, YJ, was in the zone.
Oh.
Do we have to call you that?
You clutched up.
I have to call myself that.
Did you say that while you were on stage?
I did. MC part went pretty good, but once the auction started, just something came over me.
That was the best.
I locked in, and it was like my mind opened up. The numbers were just coming through.
Jeff.
I was talking faster than I've ever talked in my entire life.
Really? Maybe this is your calling.
I even helped with a live birth on the floor
while raising money at the same time.
No way. Okay.
Why would somebody be giving birth?
Because I could do anything I wanted at that moment.
Okay.
God smiled on me in that evening.
Okay.
It could have been because I had 3 Moscow mules before I started doing this.
Oh, yeah.
But that's like a slurring
type of thing. Yeah, in his head, he's doing well. He's like, hey, he's right over here. Give me another drink.
It's possible.
Do you want this?
But by the end of the night,
I'm killing it.
We had raised $300,000 for this charity. So I felt really good about
that. Was that a record for the charity for the night?
I didn't ask if that was a record. I was just feeling really good about myself.
Awesome.
Wow.
Immediately went online and booked 5 other gigs.
Oh, God.
So We've lost you.
That was after another 3 Moscow Mules. Back to being screwed again.
Yeah.
Super nervous.
Dude, that's awesome. Congratulations. I'm glad it went so well.
Yeah, but it's not about me. It's about the kids.
Yeah. You made it seem like that on stage. But we know you were really
But secretly, I was like, yes. Let's go. That's it, YJ. Anyway.
Oh, my God. Text in.
Watch, one rich person just donated $300K. Yeah, I feel bad for the weird auctioneer guy.